السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Yesterday was عيد الأضحى for us. And today?
أيام التشريق.
أيام التشريق. يوم من أيام التشريق. That is 3 days following عيد الأضحى. That's 11th, 12th and 13th are called أيام التشريق. أيام التشريق. So, in Saudi Arabia. And as well as in Kerala. It was the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, that is Yawm Eid al-Adha was yesterday. Okay, Lakshadweep, it is today. And today we shall learn one hadith regarding the singing of songs by two girls in the house of Aisha radiallahu anha, in the presence of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the second or latter part of the hadith is about the praying of the black people or the Ethiopians the masjid during the period of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Aisha radiallahu anha watched their play in the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then Sahih al-Bukhari Kitab al-Aidain, under that kitab باب الحراب والدرق يوم العيد, a display of spears and shields on Eid festival day. حدثنا أحمد, then the سند goes, أن عائشة قالت دخل علي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعندي جاريتان تغنيان بغناء بعاث, فالتجعل الفراش وحول وجهه, ودخل أبو بكر فانتهرني, قال مزبارة الشيطان عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, فأقبل عليه رسول الله عليه السلام فقال دعهما, فلما غفل غمزتهما فخرجتا, وكان يوم عيد يلعب السودان بالدرق والحراب, فإما سألت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فإما قال تشتهين تنورين, فقلت نعم, فأقامني وراءه خدي على خدي وهو يقول دونكم يا بني أرفدة حتى إذا مللت قال قال حسبك, قلت نعم, قال فاذهبي. Narrated Aisha radiallahu anha. This hadith is reported by Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, دخل علي, قالت دخل علي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعندي جاريتان. One day, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came to my house, and near me there were two girls, jariyatan, banat, jariyatan means two girls. Tughanniyani bi ghina ibu'ath, they were singing the songs of bu'ath. Bu'ath means a war that fought between the two tribes of Aus and Khazraj in their pre-Islamic period or before their coming to Islam. So they were Ansari people, okay? And before their coming to Islam, they were enemies. They fought with each other regarding so many matters or trivial issues. And among the wars that fought between them, the last one was Bu'ath, called Bu'ath. Bu'ath. And there were many songs about this Bu'ath war. And out of those songs, some songs were sung by or were singing. These girls were singing some of the songs of the Bu'ath, Yom Bu'ath, the day of Bu'ath. It is the day of the war of Bu'ath. Okay. Then, فَالْتَجَعَ عَلَى الْفِرَاشِ وَحَضَّلَ وَجْهَا. Then, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lay down in the firash, in the bed. And, وَحَوَّلَ وَجْهَا. حَوَّلَ وَجْهَا. He turned his face to the other side. Okay. Then, وَدَخَلَ أَبُو بَكَر. Then, there came Abu Bakr. Who was Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu?
Aisha radiallahu
anhu. Yes. Aisha radiallahu anhu's father. Aisha radiallahu anhu's father. Switch off that fan. is then Aisha radiallahu anha's father. Okay, you know, the wife of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Aisha radiallahu anha. Okay, and she was the daughter of Abu Bakr radiallahu anha. And there came Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Seeing this when he was entering the house, Aisha was there. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was laying down, laying there on the bed, and these two girls were singing a song of the day of Bu'ath. Okay, then actually Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu thought that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sleeping, because he was the entire body was covered with clothes. Okay, the sharah will be coming later. Okay, inshallah. Then fantaharani, then he scolded me. Who scolded her? Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, her father scolded her. Then why? Because she permitted this song here near the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Near Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Faqal, then he said, is maradu shaytan and the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the mizmar to shaitan, musical instruments of Satan, near the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You're playing, you're permitting this. Okay, fa aqbala alayhi rasulullah alayhi salam, then the messenger of Allah alayhi salam or sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came forward, or he said what? Faqal, then he said, darhuma wa Abu Bakr, darhuma, leave both of them, no problem. Falamma ghafala, then when Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was inattentive, he was not listening, then he was inattentive. When he was even inattentive, ghamaztuhuma, I signaled to those two girls to go out. Okay, fa kharajata, then both of them went out. Okay, wa kana yawm eid, then the latter part of the hadith, and it was on an eid day. Yal'abu Sudan, Sudani people or the black people. Sudan means black people. Of Sudan also. In many of the hadiths, it is given Habsha, the people of Habsha. Habsha or Ethiopia. Okay, the people of Ethiopia. Black people. They were playing with the Bidaraqi wal Hirab, with the shields, Parija, and the spears, Kutuwalagal. They were playing. فإما سألت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فإما قال تشتهين تنظرين. Then either I asked Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم or requested Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم my wish to see or watch the play. Okay, with the armaments they were playing. Then well, or he asked me whether I wanted to see it, watch it. Tastahina tandurina. You wanted to watch it? Do you want to watch it? You wish. Then. Faqult. Then I said. Who said? Aisha. Radiallahu anha said. Now. Yes. I want to see it. Then. Faqamani wara'ah. Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made me stand behind him. Okay. Wara means behind. Amam means front. Yameen means the right side. Shimal means the left side. Okay. Then. فَأَقَامَنِي وَرَأَهْ خَضِّي عَلَى خَضِّي, my face attaching to his face. خَضِّي عَلَى خَضِّي, upon his face. Then. فَهُوَ يَقُولْ, then he was saying. That is, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was also watching this play. Then. With his wife, Aisha radiallahu anha. دُونَكُمْ يَا بَنِي أَرْفِدَهْ. Go on, continue. Banu Arfida. So he was encouraging the people to play. Okay. Then Hatta Ida Maliltu, till I was fed up with. Oh, it was enough for me. Then Qala. Then he said, Hasbuki, enough for you? Enough for you? Sufficient. Okay. Then Qultu. Then I said, Naam, yes. قَالَ فَضْحَبِي, then you may go. Okay, leave. Now the sharah or the explanation given in Fathul Bari by Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani for this hadith. You can listen here. حدثنا أحمد. Bukhari says, حدثنا أحمد. He is the son of Swalih, or he is Ibn Swalih. Then half of the reporters of this hadith are Makkis. So in the chain of reporters, in the sanad of this hadith, half of the reporters are of Makkans, of Makkah, that is Makkis, Makkans. Then the other half belong to Medina, Madinis. Okay. قوله دخل على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. زاد في رواية الزهري أن أروى في أيام مني. Then in the report of Zuhri, it is there. Aisha radiallahu anhu says, دخل علي على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then there it is. في أيام مني. That is one of my days. That is, it was her turn. Okay. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has got another wives too. Okay. Follow. Then that day was her turn. Aisha radiallahu anha's turn. So on that day, this incident occurred. Okay. Then. قوله جارية زاد في الباب الذي بعده من جوار الأنصار. وللطبراني من حديث أم سلمة أن إحداهما كانت لحسان بن ثابت. No. The two girls were Ansari girls, as it is evident from the next bab. So, in the next bab, another hadith is there. So, there it is given, min Jawaril Ansar. So, they were the girls of Ansar. Okay, from among the Ansar, Ansar people. You know, Muhajir and Ansar. Muhajir means those who migrated from Makkah to Medina. Ansar means those who helped the Muhajirs. Okay, those who received the Muhajirs as their brothers and sisters. Okay, then. And the name of one of the girls is given as Zainaba. Zainab. Okay, then. قَوْلُهُ تُغَنِّيَانِ زَالَ فِي رِوَايَةِ الزُّهْرِي تُدَفِّفَانِ بِفَائِنْ أَيْ تَضْرِبَانِ بِالدُّفِّ وَلِمُسْلِمٍ فِي رِوَايَةِ هِشَامِ أَيْضًا تُغَنِّيَانِ بِالدُّفِّ وَلِلنَّسَاءِ بِالدُّفَّيْنِ وَالدُّفُّ بِضَمِّ الدَّالِ عَلَى الْأَشْهَرِ وقد تفتح ويقال له ايضا الكربال بكسر الكاف وهو الذي لا جلاجل فيه فان كانت فيه فهو المزهر. نو تغنياني. Here the words are used. The words used are تغنياني. They were singing. They were singing. In the report of Zuhri, it is there تدففاني. تدففاني. They were playing دف. دف. Or دف. تضرباني بالدف. اي تضرباني بالدف. They were playing with the دف. And singing and play. Okay, then duf or duf, you know. Have you seen so much? Then in the report of Muslim, it is tughanniyani biduffin. They were singing with the duf, that is play, singing and play together. Okay, then so here duf and duf is there. Both usages are there, but duf is more prevalent or famous. Then it is also called kirbal. Okay, and it has no jaras on it or bell on it. Then if there is jaras, it is called mizhar. Okay. Now وفي هذه الباب الذي بعده بما تقبلت به الأنصار بيوم بعاث أي قال بعضهم لبعض من فخر أو هجاء وللمصنف في الهجرة بما تغازفت بمهملة وزاي وفاء من الأزف وهو الصوت الذي هو دفي وفي رواية قاذفت بقاف بدل العين وضال معجمة بدل الزاي وهو من القذف وهو هجاء بعضهم لبعض. No, they are singing the songs about Bu'ath, about the day of Bu'ath, about the war of Bu'ath. The Bu'ath songs were sung by two groups of provoking and laughing at each other. So out of those songs, they were singing some songs. Okay. It was regarding the day of Bu'ath. Okay, then. Wali Ahmad min Tariq min Rivayat Hamad bin Salama an Hisham idhukuru. Anna yawma Bu'ath yawma qutila fihi swanadi idhul awsi wal khazraj. Wa Bu'ath bidhammi al-muwahada ba'daha muhmala wa akhiruhu muthallatha. Qala Qliyad wa man tabi'ahu a'jamaha. Abu Abayda wahad. Wa qala ibn al-Athir fi kamil a'jamaha. No. In the report of Imam Ahmad, we see the day of Bu'ath was the day on which the soldiers or the people of the tribes of Aus and Khazraj were killed during the war between them in the pre-Islamic period, in the Jahiliyyah period. Okay. It is said that Bu'ath was the name of the fort of Aus. Aus and Khazraj, the two tribes of Medina. Okay. Then it was said that, Bu'ath was the name of the fort, palace of Aus. Also, there are views that it was a place in Medina. The name of a place in Medina, Bu'ath. Different views are there. And it was used by the tribe of Banu Qurayla to store their crops. So, these are different opinions. Then, قال الخطابي يوم بعاث يوم بعاث يوم مشهور من أيام العرب كانت فيه مقتلة عظيمة للأوس على الخزرج وبقية الحرب قائمة 120 سنة إلى الإسلام على ما ذكر منه إسحاق وغيره قلت تبعه على هذا جماعة من الشراح من شراح الصحيحين وفيه نظر لأنه يهم أن الحرب التي وقعت يوم بعاث دامت هذه المدة وليست كذلك فسيأتي في أوائل الهجرة قول عائشة كان يوم بعاث يوما قدمه الله لرسوله فقدم المدينة وقد اقترف ملؤهم نو No, the war of Bu'as was just before 5 years before Hijra. So regarding this Bu'as, there are different opinions. Then, anyhow, the war of Bu'as occurred 5 years before Hijra, before the migration from Makkah to Medina. And the event was very popular among them. Now, دامت الحرب بين الحيين الأوس والخزرج المدة التي ذكرها في أيام كثيرة شهيرة وكان أولها فيما ذكر ابن إسحاق وهشام بن الكلبي وغيرهما أن الأوس والخزرج لما نزلوا المدينة وجدوا اليهود مستوطنين بها فحالفوهم وكانوا تحت قهرهم ثم غلبوا على اليهود في قصة طويلة بمساعدة أبي جبل ملك غزان الصان فلم يزالوا على اتفاق بينهم حتى كانت أول حرب وقعت بينهم حرب سمير بالمهم. Then بسبب رجل يقال له كعب من بني سعلوة نزل على مالك بن عجلان الخزرجي فحالفه قتله رجل من الأوس يقال له سمير فكان ذلك سبب الحرب بين الحيين ثم كانت بينهم وقائع من أشهرها يوم السرارة بمهملات ويوم فارع نو There occurred a number of wars among the two tribes of Aus and Khazraj. Okay, for long periods for different reasons. And these were before their embracing Islam. You see. Okay, then Ibn Ishaq, Hisham ibn al-Kalbi and others report that when the tribes of Aus and Khazraj came to Medina, they saw there the inhabitants of the Jews. So the inhabitants in Medina were the Jews. Okay. So when Aus and Khazraj came there in Medina, the inhabitants there in Medina were Jews. Jews. Aus and Khazraj, not Jews. Okay. Follow. Then they made treaty with this Jews. Sandhi undaki vrithamali onnichu jeevikkan. Then they were initially they were under the control of the Jews. So the Jews were the inhabitants there. They were there earlier itself. Okay. Aus and Khazraj, the tribe of Aus and Khazraj came later on only. So they were under the control of the Jews. But later they became prominent. The Aus and the Khazraj. And they lived amicably, very friendly. Both the tribes were very friendly. Okay. Then they overpowered the Jews with the help of the king Abu Jalaba. Abu Jalab. King Abu Jalaba. Okay. King of Ghazan. And for a long time the tribes were living amicably or friendly. Both the tribes, Aus and Khazraj, not enemies. Then friends. Okay, allies. Then the first war erupted between the two tribes of Aus and Khazraj. Why? Because of a man. Why? There, a man from the tribe of Banu Salaba. Banu Salaba came there. And he was the guest of Malik ibn Ajlan al-Khazraji of the tribe of Khazraj. He was the guest. And he made a treaty with him, this person of Khazraj tribe. Okay. The person called a name is not given. He was belonging to the tribe of Banu Salam. Okay. Then a man from the tribe of Aus killed the person. Now, follow. A man came there and he was the guest of the one of the Khazraj. And a man from Aus called Sumair killed this person. Okay, this person. So, actually, he is an ally of, or he is living along with the Khazraj. Okay, then this was the reason for the eruption of war between the two tribes. Then there occurred so many wars for different reasons, for months, for years. Okay, and so many wars were fought between them. And Yawm Sarara, Yawm Farya, Yawm Al-Fijar the first, Yawm Al-Fijar the second, war of Husayn ibn Aslat, war of Hatib ibn Qais and Bu'as are the important wars that fought between these two tribes. Important wars, the names of important wars fought between Aus and Khazraj, both the tribes. Okay, then the last war. We are saying about, yes,
Bu'as,
the war of Bu'as. Okay. Now, وَكَانَ رَئِيسِ الْأَوْسِ فِيهِ خُلَيْرْ وَالِدْ أَسِيدْ وَكَانَ يُقَالَ لَهُ خُلَيْرُ الْكَتَائِبُ وَجُرِهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ ثُمَّ مَاتَ بَعْدَ مُدَّةٍ مِنْ جِرَاحَتِهِ وَكَانَ رَئِيسُ الْخَزْرَجِ عَمْرُ بْنِ النُّعْمَانِ وَجَاءَهُ سَهْمٌ فِي الْقِتَالِ فَصَرَغَهُ فَهُزِمُوا بَعْدَ أَنْ كَانُوا قَدِ اسْتَهْزَرُوا. Then, in the war of Bu'as, the captain, the leader of the tribe of Aus was Khulair al-Kataib. Khulair al-Kataib, the leader of the captain or the captain of Aus, the tribe of Aus was Khulair al-Kataib. Khulair al-Kataib, his name. Okay, Khulair al-Kataib. Khulair al-Kataib, and he was injured during the war. Jurh means injury. Jurh. He was injured during the war. Injury. Murivundai. Then, and after a few days, he died out of that injury. And because of that injury, he died. Then, the captain of Khazraj was Amr ibn Nu'man. The leader of Khazraj was Amr ibn Nu'man. And he was hit by an arrow. Okay. So, hence there were many songs spread among them about these wars. Okay. About the war of Bu'ath. Okay. The incidents there occurred. Then, they recorded many songs of Bu'az in their kitabs, in their dawaveen, in their song books. Okay, then. So the girls mentioned in this hadith were singing one of such songs. One or such songs about the valor and actions of the soldiers. Okay, the courage of soldiers. So each tribe will praise the soldiers of their own, their tribe. Okay, then there will be songs. Sung by then. قوله فالتجع على الفراش في رواية الزهري المذكورة أنه تغشى من بثوبه وفي رواية لمسلم تسجع أي التف بثوبه. In the report of Muslim and Zuhri, it is there, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was laying in the bed and also she was covering the body with the clothes. Okay. قوله وجاء أبو بكر في رواية هشام بن عروة في الباب الذي بعده دخل عليه أبو بكر وكأنه جاء زائرا لها بعد أن دخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came here for a visit to see his daughter. Okay. And at that time Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم was laying there in the bed. So see, he thought that he was sleeping. Okay. Now قوله فانتهرني. So Fantaharani, Aisha says, Aisha radiallahu anha says, Fantaharani. Then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, my father, he scolded me. في رواية الزهري فانتهرهما. In the report of Zuhri it is, he scolded both of the girls. Okay, so there is chance for scolding both the three persons. Whom? Aisha radiallahu anha and the two girls. The two girls for singing and Aisha radiallahu anha for permitting the song. Okay, it is fantaharuma ay al-jariyatain. It is the two girls. Wa yajma' bi annahu sharaka baynahunna fil intihar wa zajr. Amma al-Aisha tu li taqririha wa amma al-jariyatani fali fi'lihima. Okay, then. قوله مزمارة الشيطان أبو بكر الله نسج مزمارة الشيطان this musical instruments of Satan بكسر الميم يعني الغناء أو الدف لأن المزمارة أو المزمارة مشتق من الزمير وهو الصوت الذي له الصفير ويطلق على الصوت الحسن وعلى الغناء وسميت به الآلة المعروفة التي يزمر بها وإضافتها إلى الشيطان من جهة أنها تلهي فقد تشغل الكلب القلب عن الذكر. The word mizmarat means song or daf. The word mizmar is derived from the word zamir. Then, which means attractive sound or song. Then, it's also used to denote musical instrument. Mizmar is also used to denote musical instruments. Here it is such a harmonium like that. Okay, it's also called mizmar. Then, here it is such as related to Satan, Shaytan, as it obstructs the remembrance of Allah. Okay? It may obstruct the remembrance of Allah. Then, وَفِي رِوَايَةِ حَمَّادِ بِنِ سَلَمَةِ عِنْدَ أَحْمَدْ فَقَالْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ عَبِ مَزْمُورِ الشَّيْطَانِ عِنْدَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So, in the report of حَمَّادِ بِنِ سَلَمَةِ, recorded by Imam Ahmad, it is there. That is, Abu Bakr Allah said, Ya Ibadullah, oh the slaves of Allah. Abi Mazmur Shaitan in the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are playing musical instruments near Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then, قال القرطبي المزمور الصوت ونسبته إلى الشيطان ذم على ما ظهر لأبي بكر وضبطه عيال بضم الميم وكيفته. Then, Imam Qurtubi says, Mazmur or Muzmur. Both reports are there. Okay. Mazmur or Muzmur. The sound. It means sound. Here it is related by Abu Bakr Allahu Anhu to Satan or Shaytan as or according to what he understood. Okay. Then. قوله فأقبل عليه في رواية الزهري فكشف النبي عليه السلام صلى الله عليه وسلم عن وجهه وفي رواية فليه فكشف رأسه وقد تقدم أنه كان ملتفه. Then. In one report it is there. فكشف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن وجهه. So. Hearing the statement of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam removed his clothes from his face or from his head to reply to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Okay, follow. Then قوله دعهما زاد في رواية هشام يا أبا بكر إن لكل قوم عيدة وهذا عيدنا. Then here only دعهما is given. دعهما. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Abu Bakr, دعهما. Leave them. Leave both of them. Don't mind. No problem. Let them sing. In the report of Hisham, it is there. Ya Abu Bakr, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ عِيدًا وَحَاذَ عِيدُنَا. Oh Abu Bakr, for every people, for every society, there is عيد or festival. And this is our عيد. So let them sing. Permit them. Don't scold them. Okay. Then, ففيه تغليل الأمر بتركها وإيلاه خلاف ما ظنه الصديق بأن أنهما فعلتا ذلك بغير علمه صلى الله عليه وسلم لكونه دخل فوجده مغطى بثوبه فظنه نائما فتوجه له الإنكار على ابنته من هذه الأوجه مستصحبا لما تقرر عنده من منع الغناء واللهو فبادر إلى إنكار ذلك قياما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بذلك مستندا إلى ما ظهر له فأوضح له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الحالة وعرفه الحكمة مقرونا ببيان الحكمة بأنه يوم عيد أي يوم سرور شرعي فلا ينكر فيه مثل هذا كما لا ينكر فيه في الأغراس. Then النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said to Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه to Leo. Then the girls singing to leave the girls. What? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu to leave the girls sing. That means to permit the girls to sing. Okay, leave them. Then there is a clarification, an explanation about what Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu misunderstood. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu misunderstood that or thought that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sleeping because he saw Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam covering the entire body with the clothes. So he thought that he was sleeping. So then they were singing near his daughter Aisha radiallahu anha. Okay. Then it will be a disturbance or nuisance for sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he misunderstood that, like that. That's why he scolded them. Okay. So this is the clarification, explanation. So, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam removed his clothes. Then only Abu Bakr understood that he was not sleeping. Okay. Follow. Then. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarified that such types of songs are permissible in these types of festivals like Eid. Okay. Then. As it is permissible on the days of wedding, Aghras, the days of wedding, Urus, Vars, Urs, Varan, Vadu, Urs, Ursa, Urusa, Arusa, Vadu, Arusa, Vadu, Arusa, Vadu, bride and red blue. Okay. وبهذا يرتفع الإشكال أما من قال كيف صاغ للصديق إنكار شيء أقره النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وتكلف جوابا لا يخفى تعسفه. Those who doubt why Abu Bakr disliked what Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam permitted or approved. So, for those people who doubt, it will be cleared by this. Okay. Because he thought that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was? Yes.
Lying.
How? Sleeping. Okay. Not lying just. Then. وفي قوله لكل قوم أي من الطوائف قوله عيد أي كالنيروز والمهرجان. Then. The words of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For every society, there is Eid, there is festival. Okay, follow. Then it is like Mihrjan or Nairuz, the festivals of Persians. So, for Persians, there are festivals. So, for every society, there is festival means, just like Persians have festivals of Nairuz and Mihrjan. And for us, it is Eid. Today. So, this is festival day. Let them sing. Okay. Then. Yawm surur shara'iyya. That is, it is a happy moment, happy day. It is legal. Okay. Permitted. وَفِي النَّسَائِي وَبِنْ هِبْوَانِ بِسْنَادٍ صَحِيحٍ أَنَسْ قَدِمَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الْمَدِينَةِ وَلَهُمْ يَوْمَانِ يَلْعَبُونَ فِيهِمَا فَقَالَ قَدْ أَبْدَ لَكُمُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى بِهِمَا خَيْرًا مِنْهُمَا يَوْمَ الْفِطْرِ وَالْأَضْحَى واستنبط منه كراهة الفرح في أغياد المشركين والتشبه بهم وبالغ الشيخ أبو حفص الكبير النسفي من الحنفية فقال من أهدى به بيضة إلى مشرك تظليما لليوم فقد كفر بالله تعالى واستنبط من تسمية أيام منى بأنها أيام عيد مشروعية قضى صلاة العيد فيها لمن فاتته كما سيأتي بعد. Then here in the report of Nasa'i and Ibn Hibban, with the authentic chain of narrations or with Sahih reports, and Anas, it is narrated by Anas radiallahu anhu, there it says, قَدِمَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ الْمَدِينَةِ. When Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم entered or came to Medina, then وَلَهُمْ يَوْمَانِ يَلْعَبُونَ فِيهِمَا. There were 2 days for the Medina people. Medina people, there were 2 days. Before the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam itself, there were 2 days for the Medina people. Yawman yal'abuna fihima. They will be playing in those days. So they are festival days, 2 days. Faqal, then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, qad abdalakum Allah ta'ala bihima khayran minhuma. Allah has given you badal or replaced this one, these 2 days of yours with another 2 days of Eidul Adha and Eidul Fitr. So Allah has given you two another days. Another 2 days. Allah has given. Another 2 days. Allah has given you another 2 days. Eidul Fitr and Eidul Adha. So it means that now, from now onwards, you should celebrate these 2 days, not the other 2 days. Okay? Wastumbita minhu. And it is taken or derived from this hadith that karahatul farah fi awyadil mushtikeen. That is, farah or enjoying or becoming happy in the days of the festivals of mushrikeen, polytheists. It is not permitted, or it is disapproved, or it is karahat, or it is hated, disapproved. Then, وَالتَّشَبُّهِ بِهِمْ أَنْ الشَّيْخ أَبُو حَفْصَ الْكَبِيرِ النَّسَفِي بَالَغَ الشَّيْخُ. He went to the extent of saying that, he said, what? مَنْ أَخْدَى فِيهِ بَيْضَةً إِلَىٰ مُشْرِكْ تَغْلِيمًا لِلْيَوْمِ فَقَدْ كَفَّرَ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ. Whoever gave a gift of an egg to a polytheist in the festival day, in his festival day, then he denied Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, respecting the festival day. So whoever gave an egg, respecting their festival, respecting this polytheistic festival, to a non-Muslim friend, then he denied Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he went to the extent of saying that. We may seem that it is an extreme view, but actually Islam strictly prohibits and forbids polytheism. Okay? Because this type of giving gifts may encourage or promote polytheism, promote shirk and such things. Okay, that's why it is said like that. Strictly by the Imam. Here, the Imam Nasafi, Abu Hafs al-Kabir al-Nasafi, he is not against giving gifts to non-Muslims. Giving gifts to non-Muslim friends or non-Muslim neighbors, it is okay. It is good. We should respect our neighbors. Akrim jaraka walau kana kafira. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, akrim jarak, respect your neighbor walau kana kafira, even if he is a disbeliever, a non-believer, or a polytheist like that. Even if your neighbor is a polytheist or an atheist, even then you should respect your neighbor. Okay? Then, still, we should not participate or promote polytheism. That's the point. So giving gift, okay. But giving gift respecting their festival is prohibited here by Imam Abu Hafs al-Kabir al-Nasbi, according to his view. Then, baylat means egg. واستدل جماعة من الصوفية بحديث الباب على إباحة الغناء وسماعه بآلة وبغير آلة. A group of Sufis have taken proof from this hadith to permit songs with or without musical instruments. So, a group of Sufi people said that, or taken proof from this hadith, that it is permitted to sing songs with or without musical instruments. But ويكفي في رد ذلك تصريح عائشة في الحديث الذي في الباب بعده بقولها وليست بمغنيتين فنفت عنهما من طريق المعنى ما أثبته لهما باللفظ لأن الغناء يطلق على رفع الصوت وعلى الترنم الذي تسميه العرب النصب. Then, but there stand The Sufis stand can't be right. It is not true. Ibn Hajar says. Because in one report we see Aisha radiallahu anha saying, وَلَيْسَتَا بِمَغَنِّيَتَيْنِ and those two girls were not singers. Hence, it is clear that those two girls were not such professional singers. They were merely singing songs. Okay. Eh? So, ghina means, ghina is with certain type of tarannum or tamteet or taksin, taksir or tahyij or tashbih. All these are rules related to music. Eh? So, perfect singing or professional singers will be obeying all these rules when singing. But these girls were simply merely singing songs. Okay. They were not professional singers. Then, Imam Qurtubi says, the words of Aisha radiallahu anha, laysata bimghaniyatayn, they were not singers, means that they did not know how to sing properly as the well-known singers of the time. Okay. Eh? And there is no difference of opinion among the scholars that all types of songs which describes the beauty of women and lust, liquor, describing the lust, liquor, wine and prohibited things and which arouse lusty emotions or lusty feelings in the minds of people, such songs are strictly prohibited. And there is no difference of opinion among the scholars regarding that prohibition. Okay. No. Now we see the type of songs with instruments we just mentioned above here, as permitted by some Sufis. With no doubt, it is prohibited. Actually, shahwat of the body has overpowered even the good people, Ibn Hajar says, about the Sufis, such Sufis. And some of the Sufis even go to the extent that they move on dancing with a special type of body movements and act like small children, subiyan, or majanin, that is, insane people, mad people. And then they say that all these actions are to get them near to Allah. But such actions are actually the signs of atheism and the views of the people of Khurafat. Then, may Allah help him. It is inevitable to act and propagate against such things. So here the text in Arabic we shall read here. وَأَمَّا مَا ابْتَدَعَهُ الصُّوفِيَّةُ فِي ذَلِكَ فَمِنْ قَبِيلِ مَا لَا يَخْتَلَفُ فِي تَحْرِيمِهِ لَكِنَّ النُّفُوسَ الشَّهْوَانِيَّةَ غَلَبَتْ عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِمَّنْ يُنْصَبُ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ لَا حَتَّى لَقَدْ ظَهَرَتْ مِنْ كَثِيرٍ مِنْهُمْ فِغْلَاتُ الْمَجَانِينِ وَالصِّبْيَانِ حَتَّى رَقَصُوا بِحَرْقَاتٍ مُتَطَابِقَةٍ وَتَقْطِيعَاتٍ مُتَلَاحِقَةٍ وَانْتَهَى التَّوَاقُهُ بِقَوْمٍ مِنْهُمْ إِلَى أَنْ جَعَلُوهَا مِنْ بَابِ الْقُرَبِ وَصَالِحِ الْأَعْمَالِ وأن ذلك يثمر السنين الأحوال وهذا للتحقيق من آثار الزندفة. These are signs of atheism, زندفة, وقهر أهل المخرفة. والله المستعان, may Allah help us. ينبغي أن يعكس مرادهم. And we should work against them, against such things, such ideas. Then. No, but as far as musical instruments are concerned, whether it is permissible or not, there are different discussions among the scholars. It will come later, Imam says. Some say it is permitted and there is consensus among the or agreement among the scholars, while others say it is not permitted. So difference of opinion are there. وَأَمَّا إِلْتِفَاتُهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ بِثَوْبِهِ فَفِيهِ إِغْرَاضٌ عَنْ ذَلِكَ لِكَوْنِ مَقَامِهِ يَقْتَضِي أَنْ يَرْتَفِعَ عَنِ الْإِصْغَاءِ إِلَى ذَلِكَ. The words of Aisha radiallahu anha. The Prophet turned his face the other side, denotes that he didn't listen to music or song, as it is not suited to his high status. Okay, then. لكن عدم إنكاره دال على تصديق مثل ذلك على الوجه الذي أقره إذ لا يقر على باطل والأصل التنزه عن اللعب واللهو فيقتصر على ما ورد فيه النص وقتا وكيفية تقليلا لمخالفة الأصل الله أعلم. No, but the fact that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't prevent the girls from singing implies that such types of songs are allowed. He didn't prevent them, okay, from singing. Because he approved it And we know he would not approve Bapuri. Okay? But basically, one should prefer to keep away from Lahu and Laghib. It is, basically, it is the good thing. Then, and Allah knows the best. Then, from this hadith, it is to be learned that we may show some liberalism on Eid occasions towards our family members. And in such matters, so as to enable them to have some happiness, ease of mind, and freshness of body. Hearing the songs and like that and the like. Okay. وفيه جواز دخول الرجل على بنته وهي عند زوجها إن كان له بذلك عادة وتأديب الأب بحضرة الزوج وإن تركه الزوج إذ التأديب وظيفة الآباء والعطف مشروع من الأزواج للنساء وفيه الرفق بالمرأة واستجلاب مودتها وأن مواضع أهل الخير تنزه عن اللهو واللغو فإن لم يكن فيه إثم إلا بإذنهم وفيه أن التلميذ إذا رأى عند شيخه ما يستكره مثله بادر إلى إنكاره ولا يكون في ذلك افتئات على شيخه بل هو أدب منه ورعاية لحرمته وإجلال لمنصبه وفيه فتوى التلميذ بحضرة شيخه بما يعرف من طريقته ويحتمل أن يكون أبو بكر ظن أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نام فخشي أن يستيقظ فيغضب على بنته فبادر إلى سد هذه الذريعة. No, from this hadith throws like two different facts. It is permissible for a father to visit his daughter when she leaves with her husband. Then father should educate his daughter even in the presence of her husband. So if you are married to some men, then if I comes, if your father comes, if I comes to your house, then if I watch some dislike thing on your part, then can I scold you in the presence of your husbands? Can I scold you or not? Yes or not? You say yes or not? You say yes or not?
Yes.
Why? Here it is proof. You said no. So don't act such actions, such deeds. Okay? In future, inshallah. It can be. I can tell you. Okay? I can tell you. Because here Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu scolded whom? Aisha radiallahu anha. In the presence of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha's husband. Okay. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, father of Aisha radiallahu anha. Got the point? Then. So, though her husband keep silence. Sometimes husband may be keeping silent. Silence. Then, even then, father can educate his daughter. Then, this is because it is the duty and responsibility of a father to educate or to give training, ta'adib, to train you in adab, to train daughters, to train his daughter in how to behave, like that. So it is the duty and responsibility of the father. Okay, then. And as far as husband is concerned, it is expected from him to show sympathy and love towards his wife. Okay, then kindness towards one's wife and attracting her love is also implied in this hadith. Then keeping away from silly recreations and plays by virtuous people. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam turned his face to the other side. Okay, then the disciple or people should come forward to prevent an action which he felt improper. So here, Abu Bakr felt that it is not proper to sing songs like this, especially in the presence of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he thought that he was sleeping. Okay. So even in the presence of his teacher. So his teacher here, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then, and this is not belittling or one's teacher, but it is giving due respect and reverence to his teacher. Okay, then if giving fatwa by the disciple or the people, the student, in the manner one knows, in the manner he knows, when one see a seemingly unacceptable or disliking thing, even in the presence of teacher. So, Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu scolded his daughter. Okay. So, now the words of Aisha radiyallahu anha, فَلَمَّا غَفَلَ غَمَسْتُهُمَا فَخَرَجَتَا. When Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu was inattentive, I signaled to them and they went out. So, she, her husband, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, though he permitted the singing, she didn't want to continue because she felt the anger of her father. Okay, that's why she signaled them to go when Abu Bakr became inattentive. So after a little time, after a while, she signaled them to go out. So why didn't she say with or utter with her tongue to go out? So in the presence of a kabir or in the presence of elder ones, she felt shy to speak like that. Okay, that's why she signaled the girls to go out. Okay. So in this hadith there is proof that it is permitted to hear the songs of girls even they are not mamluka. Because Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not prevent Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu from hearing the songs, but he prevented his prevention. That is, our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prevented Abu Bakr from preventing the girls from singing. Okay. He didn't prevent Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu from hearing the songs. Okay. So, they continued the song till Aisha radiyallahu anha signaled them. Continued the song. Because they got permission from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to continue. But, last. Anna mahal al jawazi ma idha aminatil fitna bidhalika. Wallahu alam. So, this permission is only when there is no fear of fitna. So, if by hearing the song, one will go astray or one will get into haram, haram thoughts or haram actions, then it is not permitted at all. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.